gathering your data for population-based medicine. And there is no...
Wait. Hang on, Dr. George. Population-based medicine? What do you
mean
by
correct.
That? That sounds...
They're looking at sickness amongst populations, black people, women, children. They're trying to drive or get information about each of us as an individual. For example, if I write a prescription for somebody to help them stop smoking, and it's an antidepressant, I'm not using it because they're depressed. I'm using it because I want to help them stop the craving. All the system sees is that they're on an antidepressant. And that let me tell you, it goes through the entire system.
Oh, wow.
HHS looks at it. FBI looks at it. And my personal feeling is that there's nothing to stop them. If you want to get a legal handgun or get a government job from saying, hey, you had an antidepressant in your background, you must be unstable.
Wow.
This is the system that we're going into. It's not personalized at all. And you just become a data-gathering source, and they're going to apply whatever they believe about you to you, whether it's true or not.
So the Leviathan was hiding inside the Trojan horse of the Affordable Health Care Act, and then it
Absolutely.
Jumped.
Absolutely.
We let him into the city, and he jumps out, and it's really all a data grab.
No question. It's not about health care, because if they really wanted to get you better, they wouldn't be cutting off medications. For example, Medicare alone covers Avastin for uterine cancer, because it doesn't help that many people, and it's too expensive. Everybody's now a cost center. And they pay doctors now to talk about end-of-life decisions, but not to give you the medical care you need to get you better. It's outrageous.
Now I'm going to ask you a quick question. This is just personal. I don't know if you'll have an answer to it, but just your personal opinion. Mm-hmm. Do you think Obama knew about this? As a person, do you think he was aware that this was about when he was proselytizing and using the bully pulpit to kind of push this thing? Do you think he personally knew about it? I know you don't know for sure. What's your take?
Well, my take on it is nobody read the bill, but I think that they wanted this chaos because...
But him personally? Him personally?
I think no. I think, but he thought that he's in bed with single payer. He wants that. And that's what the whole system is moving towards. So obviously he didn't write the bill, neither did the Congress. It was the pharmaceutical industry, medical insurance industry. The unions were involved. Hospital corporations were involved.
They wrote the bill. They wrote the bill.
Absolutely. it's a lobby-driven bill, and it's full of pork and cronyism. These particular corporate interests, there were no doctors in there that practiced medicine. There were no patients involved. We're the last on the list.
That's unbelievable.
All we do is drive the system. We as doctors, we help help the system charge because we order the tests. And we order the prescriptions, but they don't like us very much. They want us to shut up and just keep ordering. And patients,
okay.
Don't get sick.
All right, so here's the deal. The program's the bright side. We know the bad news, and it's important that we tell people the bad news, and we
Absolutely.
Don't shut up about this. But what's the good news? Second part of your subtitle, how doctors and patients working together can rebuild a better system. What's your take? What's your vision?
The first thing that people need to understand is they need to find an independent doctor who is not in this system. There are growing numbers of doctors out there who practice medicine using the Hippocratic Oath. And if you go to a website called aapsonline.org, aapsonline.org.
What is AAPS?
It's an Association of American Physicians and Surgeons. These are independent doctors who join together. They are the anti-AMA, if you want to put it that way.
Oh, wow.
And we have doctors who specialize in practicing medicine, again, using the Hippocratic Oath. There's sliding scale, so if you don't have insurance, we make it affordable. There's direct primary care.
Wow.
There's a subscription model where you can pay. I give myself an example. $65 a month in my ear, nose, and throat practice, if people join my membership, will cover any ENT service I offer, hearing tests, allergy testing, endoscopic examination for that $65 a month. That's reasonable. And if I cut the middleman out, I can stop doing all these stupid regulations and nothing but nonsense that jacks up the price. That's going on across the country. And what there's another little pearl that people don't know about called medical cost sharing. It's written into the Affordable Care Act, but nobody ever talks about it. What it is a consortium of self-pay patients who join together, cover their own health care expenses, and they're parallel to the system. They're able to access the real costs of health care, which are about a third of what people are paying now. And I joined, and I put my office staff on it because I personally cannot deal with the insurance industry. So I'm having the most expensive policy which is $199 a month. I pay a total of $500 out of pocket per year, and I'm covered up to $1 million per occurrence per year, and I can go to any doctor, any hospital that I want. And wow. I also get benefits for holistic care as well. So if I want to do Qigong or Reiki or whatever I choose wow. to do, it's covered. That's the alternative that exists now. Patients need to know that it exists so they can make an informed choice, and that's what the book teaches people.
Now, tell me about this insurance program again, or tell the listeners like how they, because I'm sure a lot of people are going to be interested
sure.
in this.
It's called Liberty Health Share. And if
okay.
people go to libertyoncall.org, they can learn all about it. It's not new. It's been around for about 18 years, but it was a small organization. But it morphed into a more inclusive, anybody who's liberty-minded, anybody who wants to take responsibility for their own health and will voluntarily cover somebody else's, their members' health care needs.
And this is all on your website?
It's all on the website, so is the link. But it's the future, and it's actually your choice that you don't have to do the Affordable Care Act if you don't want to. You don't have to go to Aetna or Cigna or any of these other insurance companies, because trust me, they're becoming too big to fail. And the more power they get, the more they charge you, the less they pay the physician, the worse the care is going to be.
Wow, Dr. George, you are doing some super, super work. I can't tell you how grateful I am as a fellow healthcare professional for what you're doing. Just awesome stuff. The book
Thank
is Big Medicine, Dr. Elena George, and then it's DrElenaGeorge.com, DrElenaGeorge.com. Check out our blog and check out our website. And also Liberty Health, that's really cool information, LibertyOnCall.org, and then also the Association of American Physicians and Surgeons, AAPSOnline.org. Thank you so much, Dr. George. Have a great day.
Me.
Good to talk to you.
You too.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Okay, bye-bye. Yeah, that's libertyonline.org. I highly suggest you check them out if you don't want to be dealing with Obamacare. And then also aapsonline.org, and that's the Association of American Physicians and Surgeons. Check out Dr. George's website. All this information is up there, plus her blog, drelenageorge.com. All right, that's all the time we have for today. I'm Pharmacist Ben. Have yourselves a spectacular, awesome day. We'll talk to y'all later, folks. Bye for now.